This is how I teach my clients that food actually always works with their dog. If you think about it, all animals are alive because they have food and water, right? And your dog is alive because it is motivated to eat food. So therefore your dog's food motivated. Now, instead of just throwing this in your face, let me kind of go into more detail about why your dog might not be more specifically taking food when training. Now, there are a variety of reasons why your dog might not be responding to food-based training, and I'm going to go over 6 of the most common things that I see with my clients and how we get past those. Reason number 1 is that the treats you're offering your dog, they don't like it, right? Every animal and every person has their own individual tastes. A large majority of the time, dogs are not going to like crunchy biscuits. If you have a puppy, they pretty much shove anything in their mouth. But as a dog gets older, you're going to realize that maybe Fido doesn't like the crunchy treats all the time. Now, that being said, there are a lot of dogs who really, really enjoy those crunchy milk bones that you get for really cheap over at Costco. But for the majority of dogs, they don't really go bonkers for a dry biscuit. Now, something that you can try offering are different types of soft training treats. Anything that's semi-moist and really, really small, a lot of dogs tend to enjoy. And again, not all dogs enjoy them. I don't like licorice candy. I also don't like lima beans. But when somebody says, you know, oh, go reward Caitlin with some candy and then she happened to choose licorice, I'm gonna give them a side eye and be like, you're crazy. That's gross. So this step takes a little bit of time for you to figure out what your dog really likes. Again, try a bunch of those really soft treats and what most dogs tend to find irresistible. And if every once in a while, not very often, but every once in a while, I will find a dog that does not like a specific type of cheese I'm offering them. That being said, hot dog, cheese, deli meat, veggie burgers, whatever is really soft, really moist and really stinky, dogs seem to love. I mean, how many times have you taken your dog on a walk and you cross something that might not be so alive, right? How bonkers do they go over that? Really stinky, really wet, really moist. The second reason that I find that my clients' dogs aren't particularly food motivated is that they are being free fed. Now, puppies can be free fed without becoming obese, but adult dogs over a year of age really should not be free fed, depending on, you know, what your veterinarian says. There's a lot of working dogs out there that need more calories overall, but may or may not be best on a free fed diet. So when your dog is free fed, you fill up a bowl and you leave it out there for them to eat throughout the day. This has a major problem. This really is a major problem because it creates obese dogs. And if you don't know what an obese dog looks like, I encourage you to look at the chart that I've provided below for how to gauge if your dog is obese or if they're at a comfortable weight. But if you're trying to train your dog using food-based methods rather than aversive-based methods, then you really need to start looking just giving your dog a scheduled feeding time, morning or night. Morning, afternoon, night. Maybe just morning, maybe just night. People do it all different sorts of ways for all different sorts of reasons. So find what works for your dog, but put them on a schedule and don't free feed them. It's just really, really unhealthy for your animal. So if you are trying to train your dog, they are overweight, they're recently getting off of a free feeding schedule and you don't want to feed them treats because you know it's going to put on some more extra pounds, well, guess what? You can actually, now that you have a scheduled feeding time with them, feed him before the meal times for his kibble. And you can ask him to do those tricks and you make that a learning session and it becomes a really, really fun and bonding time that you can have with your dog. Now, every once in a while, I find some people that really feed their dogs a very rich and very tasty food for their main meal. And usually that's wet food and sometimes it's their own homemade cooked mash. And again, if your dog isn't motivated for those semi-soft treats, well, it really makes sense because they're getting all that really high value stuff that they love so much. So what, again, I encourage you to do, if that's your dog's diet, train them for their meals. Yeah, you're probably gonna get messy, but that's the trade-off you get if you want a trained dog as well as continue to feed them on the diet that you currently have them on. Now, the fourth reason that I often see people working with their dogs for treats and it's not working is because that they are over threshold. And when I say over threshold, it actually means that the dog is way too aroused or way too excited and cannot focus on you and is only focusing on, say, there's a dog across the street or a person or a small child running around or a duck, right? It could be anything. And if you're calling your dog's name and they're still zoning in on that thing, you are over threshold. So if you're over threshold, nothing's really gonna pull them out of it, right? So if your dog is over threshold, realize that you accidentally set them up for failure and that they're not gonna respond to you right now. But in order to get them out of over threshold, you need to back up your distance to the point they are not so over aroused anymore. And there's a lot more to go into this, but I'm not gonna go into there right now because sometimes your dog, there's an additive effect and sometimes your dog can, you know, be very far away after a recent encounter that they were really aroused at, and they're still gonna be aroused when they're that far away. So those are just kind of things to keep in mind, that the brain actually needs time to have these chemicals dissipate and to get them back into a calmer state of mind. So you might have to have a long waiting period depending on the severity of the reactivity with your dog until you try again next time and keep them under threshold. The fifth reason that treats wouldn't be working in a training session is that your dog doesn't understand. You're taking really giant leaps when you should be taking very small baby steps trying to teach your dog a behavior. A very common thing that I see with dog trainers is that instead of using a treat to guide them on the back of to the back of their head with the nose, or even if they are using this, maybe the person isn't going slow enough for their dog, they're not staying close enough to the dog's nose. So again, we're setting ourselves and our dogs up for failure by accident. And some people get frustrated and they're just gonna go back to, pushing down their dog's hip to force them into a sit, which is actually really dangerous because that can cause hip dysplasia. And you definitely don't wanna do that to young puppies because that really messes up their bone structure. So hip dysplasia is actually a $3,000 surgery per hip. So if you wanna go ahead and spend $6,000 on your dog because you're pushing on their butt, that's your choice. So if you are struggling with a behavior like teaching your dog how to sit by guiding them with a treat on their nose, you're gonna have to realize that it's not the dog's fault. The dog is doing the best that they can with the information you're providing. So adjust your training plan. If you're really having a hard time, record yourself, watch it back. A lot of the times there's certain hand signals that look very similar to a dog and they can think that what you want is one thing, but what you really want is another thing, and you're not realizing what you're doing because you're already in your own head and you're trying to work with your animal. So recording yourself and watching it back, that can really help you become a better trainer and troubleshoot the issues that you're having with yourself in training your dog. The final and sixth reason why your dog isn't working well with treats is because you're not at your own dog's pace. And I often find this with smaller dogs because they are really, really, really fast. And a lot of people aren't as fast as a small dog and aren't as reactive and able to guide the animal and like jive with the small animal. And that's often a reason why it can be a lot harder to teach smaller dogs because they're just so fast and people aren't as fast as these small dogs. So what I would suggest is to start actually looking at your dog and paying more attention to their movements and getting in tune with them. You have to start having a flow state with your animal, and it takes practice. Smaller animals can be a lot harder to train simply because of their speed. If you're interested in reading more, I have an article linked down in the description below. Visit my blog post and subscribe to my blog post as well as this channel so that you can stay up to date on all the things that are going on. I wish you a great journey with you and your pet.